Hey guys, what's up? We are here after our drunk driving in the last episode and you guys voted for it. We got pulled over by the police. And as you can see, we're still a bit shaky. Our head is still spinning a bit and the police officer is just about to hop out of his car and come and have a quick chat with us. And I just can't really see straight at the moment. Everything's blurry, everything's wobbly. And guys, he's gonna say something to us real quick. Have you been drinking tonight, sir? Yeah, but only a few. Take this breath test for me, please. You have a 0.8, which is well over the limit. You will receive a 6-month driving ban and a £2,000 fine. Guys, can you believe it? We're gonna receive a 6-month driving ban and a £2,000 fine for this, and we're gonna leave this right now. And we got taken home by the police officer. And we're back here in the office a couple of days later after we recovered. And guys, we're suspended for 6 months of driving. We've got a game coming up against Barnett and then a game against Crew. Right now, we're getting into it. But guys, can you believe it? 6 months no driving. That means we're going to have to get a personal driver, I think, just to help us get around town for the foreseeable future for the next 6 months or so. So you guys can decide who that's going to be later on in the episode. We've also got fined £2,000, which is a bit annoying. But we've got some football to play, guys. We've got some managing to do. We've got some things we've got to get sorted. And as you can see here, Barnett with a 5-2-1-2 formation. And we've got our usual lineup for Exeter City. And guys, we actually played a much, much different squad than usual here. As you can see, we changed the formation to a 4-4-2. We got Brunt and Romero up the top, Smallcombe Boateng in the middle, Engan, Klassen on the wings, and Woodman, Chancellor Brown, and Sweeney on at the back with Ruffo in goal, guys. So we've got a lot of different players playing in this game. As you know from previous episodes, the reason we got junk was because of our depressing losses and position in the table. And it's just not been good so far. So we're hoping to get bounced back here. Now that we kind of realize what we've done was stupid, driving that car, getting pulled over by the police, we're going to try and get something out of this game here today with the squad. This different squad, a weaker squad, but maybe a more positive squad with their attitude. Here we come with a chance there. Brunt having the shot, hitting the post in the 13th minute and wasn't able to hit it at the back of the net though. 23 minutes played now. Here comes a chance for Barnett. They're looking to get forward here in the midfield. They're just passing it around really nicely here. Taylor pushing forward now into the space for Nichols, getting tackled by Chancellor, but he loses possession and the player runs into space. And what a poor defensive mistake from him. Leads to the goal, makes it 1-0 here for Barnett, guys, and it's happening all over again. We've taken a 1-0 loss at the moment, and it's just not what we are needing at this stage in our career, at this stage in the season, guys. We're just losing game after game, and a poor defensive display there from Chancellor. Loses the ball, and Alex Nichols goes and scores the goal there, his first league goal in the championship, and he's made it 1-0 here against Exeter. And we're losing, guys, as we have been a lot lately. Can we pull this one back? Can we pull something out of the bag here today with this weaker squad, this young, fresh, hungry squad? We'll have to see how we go. 28 minutes in. Here comes Brunt with a chance now. He's going to let it to Romero. Romero with a chance to have a shot here. He's shot there against cross goal, but it was offside just afterwards. And it's going to be pulled up for that one. A chance here just before halftime for Barnett. They're going to lay it into the box now. Looks to get across in the area here. They're just holding it up nicely. Let's try not to get a tackle in too much. Blocked by the defense. Cleared out of play. And there goes the halftime whistle in this game. It's currently 1-0 on the scoreline to Barnett. 1-0 up for them. And we're playing quite poorly at the moment. To be honest, we've hit the post once. We had a decent chance or two. But they've been on top. They've had a goal. They've had a couple of chances, guys. And we're going to be heading into the second half looking to turn this game around. We need to turn this game around if we want to get anything out of this season. Can we do it here? A chance. 78 minutes play, guys, for Exeter. We're coming forward with a chance here for Romero. Romero pushing forward into the space now. Can he get this one away? He lays it to Klassen. Klassen with a shot across goal. And he goes and sticks it in for 1-1 into the back of the net. What a goal from Klassen. And he's gone and made it 1-1 in this game. Romero playing nicely there. A bit of unselfish play to pass it to Klassen on running onto the pitch. And goes and scores it into the back of the net to make it 1-1 here in the 80th minute, guys. We've pulled one back. We've got 10 minutes to get another one. 3 minutes later, can we do it? Coming forward with a chance, Boateng there, leaving it to Byrne there to Reed on the edge to Romero just looking to get a shot away but can't open up the space. Boateng here, we're still pushing on the edge of the area. We've got a a chance to get this one in now to make it 1-2-1 in this game. Can redo it. He's led it to Smolkin there. Smolkin with the shot and it's gone in the back of the net. We've taken a 2-1 lead in this game. 85 minutes played and this youthful squad might just have snatched the victory here today. On the edge of the box, Smolkin there. A one touch, one finish. And he's gone and slotted it into the back of the net past the goalkeeper. Max Smolkin there in the 86th minute of this game, starting in centre mid for this one. And he's gone and got the game-winning goal by the looks of it, guys. If we can just hold this till the final whistle, we will gain all 3 points here today. Barnett here with the goal kick in the 90th minute. And guys, guess what? It looks like it's all but over in this game. And there goes the final whistle. It finished 2-1 in this game. Can you believe it? We ended up getting a very, very good result out of it just in the nick of time. A goal in the 80th minute, a goal in the 86th minute, and we come away with a 2-1 victory, which was just what we needed. Very, very good from Exeter City. And a very positive result that we got coming back from that one, especially after our drunk driving incident, getting banned for 6 months. Guys, coming up later on in this episode, next we have a game against Crewe on the 16th of September. And as you can see from the table, we've pushed our way up into 18th place with 7 points, which is still pretty poor, but we are on the rise now. And we're looking to do better in this season and come away with some more results if we can, guys. So as for the personal driver, guys, these are the options for who we're going to have. There's option number one, £800. He's a very good driver, very reliable, always on time. Option number two, he's okay, not too bad. Number three is only £400, but he's not so reliable. He might not be there on time every time, but he is a good driver. Also, guys, option number four is he's actually a kid. He's a teenager. He's £200. If you guys want to get him, this is a week, £200 a week. If we want to get him in, guys, or any of them, let me know what you want to see. The kid is actually kind of unreliable, doesn't show up on time, might not even show up at all. What do you want to see us getting as our driver? Which one of these guys, more reliable, less reliable? Let me know down in the comments and in the poll above, guys. You have option 1, 2, 3, and 4. And for now, though, we are going to be getting into the next game of this episode. It's against Crewe Alexander in the EFL League 2. And we're going to look for another win in this episode. 6 points out of 6 would be ideal if we can get them. We're just shaking the hands of all the Crewe players. And hopefully we can get something out of this game, guys. It's a pretty big fixture for us. It may not look very big to everyone else, but guys, we are struggling against pretty low teams at the moment, so we need to get a win here. We're playing the same formation this game, but with a different lineup. We've got Brustad, Romero, Mitchell on the left because of the injured Casido, Klassen on the right this time, Edwards, James in the middle with Moxie, Chancellor, Moore, Taylor, and Vaskalovs at the back with Ruffo in goal. I'm giving Chancellor one more game, guys. If he doesn't perform, he will not be getting in the starting lineup anytime soon. We have got other centre-backs just as good who can take his position, and to be honest, lately he has not been playing too well. But here we are getting this game underway. Hopefully he will play well. Hopefully we can too. 5 minutes into this game, can we get something out of it now? We're looking to get forward here down the middle of the pitch. Brustad with the shot across goal, but it's just gone wide. Unlucky for him, almost opening the deadlock already, but wasn't able to do so. 17 minutes in, guys, pushing forward. Mitchell there, laying it to Edwards. Edwards to Brustad. Brustad looks to get a shot away here, turns on the edge, lays it to Klassen with the shot. Klassen's gone and put it in once again. 2 goals in 2 games for Davy Klassen, and he's gone and made it 1-0 in this game. Brustad with a nice turn on the edge there. Great ball there to Klassen, who turns as well. Finishes it into the back of the net, and it's gone in to make it 1-0 in this game. Daylon Klassen, third goal in EFL League 2 this season. And guys, it is 1-0 on the score. Not a bad goal, not a bad goal indeed. And guys, here we come with a chance for Crewe, though. They're looking to get forward there, headed away by our players, but they get a tackle in, having a shot. Great save from Ruffo to keep that one out. 28 minutes played, 45 minutes in. We're approaching halftime. There it goes, the halftime whistle in this game. Currently 1-0 to Exeter City, guys. Can we hold this lead till the final whistle and come away with another 3 points in this episode? Klassen with another goal. He's had one shot in this game, and he's playing really, really well lately. I really like him as a signing we brought into the squad. He's been doing really good. But guys, can we add to this once again? We've got Brustad playing up top. He had that dream debut a few games ago, but has done nothing since. And a great chance coming forward here for Exeter. Looks to get this one inside the box. That's a Romero. What an effort. What a save from the goalkeeper to keep that one out. Denied a 2-0 lead. And guys, 53 minutes in, another chance for Exeter. We're just bombarding at the door now. Chance for James here, getting a shot away there, getting taken out, but also getting saved by the goalkeeper. And we weren't able to put that one in the back either. Another chance here for Exeter. Can we do it? Brustad to make it 2-0 here. It's the cross Espoir. What is going on? We have not been able to finish so many chances. 72nd minute, guys, into this game. A chance here for Crew. Are they going to stick it in? A great chance at the back post. Rojo with a great save as well to keep that one out. But guys, in the 83rd minute, a chance coming forward, and they go and stick it in the back of the net. Ray there with the goal after so many chances for Exeter to make it 2-0. We couldn't capitalize, and now we've gone and paid the ultimate price. An equalizing goal from Crew has seen it go to 1-1 in the 83rd minute of this game. George Ray with the goal here just flicks it past Ruffo, and he's gone and equalized. That's so frustrating. That's his first goal of the season as well. What is going on, Exeter? How have we not scored a second? How have we not made this game and put it to bed ourselves? We just haven't been able to do so, guys. And in the 87th minute, we're coming forward with a chance here. Jake Taylor lays it there to Mitchell. Mitchell with the shot, and it's just wide off the left side of the goal. He's not able to bury that one. 90 minutes in, last chance for Crew of this game. They put it near post, headed away. Can we get this one away? There goes the full-time whistle, guys. It's not a bad result, but it's just disappointing the way we did draw it. We were winning. We had plenty of chances to go 2-0 up, and then we go and concede a goal, and it goes back to 1-1, and then the game finishes. So we gain a point from this game, 4 points from this episode in total, which isn't too bad after we've had so many losses before. And guys, we're just leaving the stadium here, as you can see. We're going to get back on the bus to go home before we hire our personal driver in the next episode from your vote. We've got Coventry coming up in the next episode, and then a game against Notts County as well on the 26th of September. And as you can see from the table, guys, we're in 18th position still. 8 games played, 8 points on the table. It's not the best of starts to a season, but we're doing okay, and we got plenty to play for still to come in this season, guys. As you can see, we've just been paid there as well, and we end up the day with $13,600 in the bank. So that's it for this episode, guys. Please give us a like, share, and subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that poll if you haven't as well, and make sure you get in on that too, guys. So give us a like. Yeah, like I said, be ready for the next episode. We've got plenty more coming from these series, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.